This is pulse oximeter showing SpO2, that is oxygen concentration in your RBCs or in your blood, and pulse rate. Well, pulse is your heart rate, the number of times your heart beats in 1 minute. Pulse decreases when you are at rest, and it increases when you are doing exercises. Should you buy a pulse oximeter in this corona pandemic?
Is it worth buying a pulse oximeter? Let's talk.
If someone has a reliable pulse oximeter and if he knows how to adequately use it, then yes, it can be beneficial to someone. Having normal oxygen level can be quite reassuring, although there is no guarantee with someone who has fast declining breathing status. It's quite possible that someone who has normal oxygen level can quickly progress to low oxygen concentration that can be life-threatening. There are so many factors come into play, like the quality of the pulse oximeter itself, and how the person is using it, or the underlying medical conditions of the person, like COPD, asthma, or any new infections, or the underlying infections which is worsening. All those things are important to consider. According to the recent ICMR guidelines, if you have a pulse oximeter, you should check your oxygen concentration every 4 hours and monitor it. If it comes less than 95%, then you should inform to the senior health inspector of the BBMP. Another factor to consider is, what is their oxygen level at baseline? I have plenty of patients who are at home and who has the oxygen level at 93%. That is their baseline and that is the best they can get. If someone normally has a baseline of 100% and now they are reading at 93%, then that is more concerning than the people who has baseline oxygen level at 93%. When someone with COVID-19 has symptoms, most common symptoms beside fever and cough is shortness of breath. Most people, but not all, with corona positive has shortness of breath. Does that mean you should run out and get one pulse oximeter? Maybe. The oxygen readings that are obtained through smartphones are not accurate. Actually, there has been one study made on that. It has shown that the pulse which is recorded on the smartphone is not reliable and can't be used for clinical uses. So though pulse oximeter is not accurate, but it is much better than the smartphones. So when it comes to coronavirus pandemic, the purpose of pulse oximeter is best served when the patient is feeling ill or when they are deciding on whether to go to the hospital or not. Keep in mind that there are some conditions which can give fast reading of the pulse oximeter, such as dark nail polish or artificial nails or nails that are too long, cold hands, or poor circulations, or high lipid in the blood, or room lighting, etc. If you have any doubts, suggestions, or any comments, kindly comment it below. Thank you for watching.